Hi everyone. With the previous sessions, we have seen solving of game theory problems with the saddle point that was already completed, and also the without saddle point games already we solved them with the help of algebraic method and the combination of algebraic method and the dominance principle. And now in the today's session, I want to discuss about the graphical method of solving the game theory problems. So with the help of the graphical method, we can able to solve two types of problems. So one is solving of games of 2 by n order payoff matrix, and also the next one is solving of games of m by 2 order games, payoff matrix order games. So these two types only we can able to solve using graphical method. So now, without any let, let us get into the solving of problems of the order 2 by n. So now here I am going to solve a problem of this type. So let us see about that one. So this one is the problem of type game 2 by n. So here this is the problem. Please see here. Consider the payoff matrix of player A as shown in table and solve it optimally using graphical method. So here this is the payoff matrix given to us, and we need to solve this by graphical method. So here if you observe, the player A is having two strategies or alternatives, that is 1 and 2, and the player B is having 5 strategies or alternatives. So the order of the payoff matrix is 2 by 5. So here the rows are only 2, but the columns may be 3 or 4 or 5 or and so on up to n. So if you want to solve this type of problems, how to solve them? So now let us see them. So in your examination, if he said or if he did not mention to solve it by graphical method, so then we need to check first of all whether this game is having a saddle point or not. So if the game is having saddle point, then no need to solve the game by using graphical method. Directly we can get the answers. So but here he has mentioned graphical method, so directly we can get into graphical method. But for our understanding purpose, I am going to solve from the first theory onwards. So that means I am going to check whether this game is having a saddle point or not. If it is having a saddle point, we can close the problem with that step. Or otherwise, if the game is not having the saddle point, I am going to solve this problem by graphical method. So now let us check whether this game is having a saddle point or not. So now this is the payoff matrix. I have rewritten it. So now we have to find whether this game is having a saddle point or not. So here, in order to find the saddle point, what are the things to be known? First, we need to find the maximin value and minimax values. So how to find the maximin value means, so we need to calculate the row minimum first of all. So what is row minimum? So now take the first row. In the first row values 3, 0, 6, minus 1, 7. What is the minimum value? Minus 1. And next, in the second row values minus 1, 5, minus 2, 2, 1. In all these 5 values, what is the minimum value? Minus 2. So these are the row minimum values for each row. Then what is the maximin value? So maximin value means whatever the maximum value in row minimums, that is the maximin value. So in minus 1 and minus 2, what is the maximum value? Minus 1 is the maximum value. So this is known as maximin value. And next, we need to calculate the minimax value. So how to find the minimax value? So in order to find that, First of all, we need to find the column maximum values. So what are the column maximum values for each column? Let us find it. So now take the first column. So in first column, the values are 3, minus 1. So in 3 and minus 1, the maximum value is 3. And next, now take the second column. In second column, 0, 5. What is the maximum value? 5. Now take the third column, 6, minus 2. So what is the maximum value? 6. Next, take the fourth column. In minus 1 and 2, what is the maximum value? 2. Next, fifth column. In 7 and 1, what is the maximum value? 7. Then we need to identify the minimax value. So now in all of the column maximum values, what is the minimum value? In 3, 5, 6, 2, 7, the minimum value is 2. So here, this value we are calling it as minimax value. We will call it as minimax value. So now observe the maximin and minimax values, whether both are equal or not. Maximin value is minus 1, minimax value is 2. So both are not equal. So therefore, this game is not having saddle point. You can say this game is not having saddle point. So if the game is not having the saddle point, then there are a number of methods are there in order to solve that. So we can solve it by dominance principle. But here it was mentioned here, we need to solve it by graphical method. So how to solve the problem by graphical method? So now let us see that one. So first of all, I am assuming here for player A, there are two strategies are available. So for those two strategies of selecting by player A, I am taking, let X be the probability of selection of strategy 1 by player A. So ante first strategy ni select chesukovadaniki enta probability undi anukuntunnam, X probability undi anukuntunnam by player A. Then what is the probability of selecting the second strategy? It will be automatically 1 minus X. We know that the sum of probability should be equals to 1. So if you do the summation, X plus 1 minus X, that equals to 1. So sum of the probabilities is equals to 1. So same like that, we can take 1 minus X be the probability of selection of strategy 2 by player A. So if we are assuming like this. So and after that, we need to get the gain functions of player A and the gain values of player A for each alternative of player B. So now let us get into that solution. So now I am going to find the A's expected payoff matrix. So now I am going to calculate the expected payoff to player A with respect to different alternatives of player B. So player B yokka different alternatives degara player A expected payoff values ni find out chestunna. So how many alternatives are there for player B? So totally there are 5 alternatives are there. So now I am going to find that one. So now I am writing them. First alternative, second alternative, third one, fourth one, and fifth one. Right? So now let us calculate the A's expected payoff gain function for each alternative of B. So now I am taking the first alternative of player B. This is the first alternative of player B. I am going to find the expected payoff for player A. So for player A, the probability of selecting the first strategy is X. Probability of selecting the second strategy is 1 minus X. So now I am calculating the gain functions. So that is for first alternative, the gain functions are. So here if you take X and here 1 minus X. So then multiply. So I am taking x here and 1 minus x here. Then 3 into x for first alternative, 3 into x plus, here the value is minus 1 into, what is the probability for strategy 2? 1 minus x into 1 minus x. So now calculate the gain function. 3x, here minus 1 you are having, 3x minus 1 plus x, then you will get 4x minus 1 is the gain function for alternative 1 of player B. Now calculate the gain function for second alternative. So then what will be the gain function? 0 into x plus 5 into 1 minus x, that equals to what will be, you will get minus 5x plus 5. Next, for third alternative, let us find 6 into x minus, actually we have to write plus, do minus 2 into 1 minus x. So then what will be the gain function? 6x, here plus 2x you will get, so totally 8x minus 2. Next, take the fourth gain function, then minus 1 into x plus 2 into 1 minus x. So that is equals to minus x minus 2x. Totally you will get minus 3x plus 2. Then for fifth alternative, let us find, for fifth alternative, 7, 1. So 7 into x plus 1 into 1 minus x. 7 into x plus 1 into 1 minus x. So that equals to 7x, here minus x. So 6x plus 1 is the gain function for alternative 5. So like this, we have to find the gain functions for each alternative of player B. So now I am rewriting those gain functions in the Billet table. So the same thing here, B's alternative, A's expected payoff function. So I am rewriting them. So first alternative, the first gain function is 4x minus 1, and second one is 8x minus 2, and third one is, second one is minus 5x plus 5, third one is 8x minus 2, and fourth one is minus 3x plus 2, and fifth one is 6x plus 1. So now we need to find the expected gains for each of the A's gain function. So now I am going to find them. So now substitute x is equals to 0 in the gain function, then we need to find this function value. So substitute x equals to 0, then 4 into 0 minus 1, you will get minus 1. Then at x equals to 1 also, we need to find this gain function value. So substitute x equals to 1 in this function, then 4 into 1 minus 1, you will get 3. So this is for first alternative of player B. Similarly, for all the remaining alternatives, we need to find the gain values. So now substitute 0 in this function, minus 5 into 0 plus 5, you will get 5. Next, substitute x equals to 1, then minus 5 into 1 plus 5. So then you will get 0. And next, for third alternative, let us find 8 into 0 minus 2. Then you will get minus 2. Substitute x equals to 1, then 8 into 1 minus 2, you will get 6. Next, fourth alternative, you take minus 3 into 0 plus 2, then you will get 2 and substitute x equals to 1, minus 3 into 1 plus 2, you will get minus 1. Next, for fifth alternative, substitute x equals to 0, then 6 into 0 plus 1, then it will be 1. And substitute x equals to 1 here, then 6 into 1 plus 1, you will get 7. So these are the gain function values at x equals to 0 and at x equals to 1. Now we need to draw these, represent these values on the graph. So now how to draw the graph in this method? Let us see. So this is the graph I have drawn for the by assuming a suitable scale. So here we need to draw two line, vertical lines first of all. So this first line will represent the x is equals to 0 gain function line. And this second line will represent the x is equals to 1 line. So now with the help of your scale, take 5 mm as a division and represent these values. 0, now take 5 mm division. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. And similarly in the bottom also, if it is 0 means in the bottom you will get minus. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, like that. Similarly, on x equals to 1 line also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. And here below also, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 6, like that. And here, it is representing 0 to 1, the duration, that is 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Here also you can take 5 mm partition. So, with that suitable scale, here I have drawn the graph. Now, the expected, the gain function values have to be represented on this graph. So, now how to represent them on the graph? So, let us see. So, now, these are the, already we got these expected gain function values. So, now let us represent these minus 1 and 3 value of the first alternative of player B. So now on x is equals to 0 is minus 1, on x equals to 1 is 3. So let us represent on x equals to 0 minus 1. So I am representing this is the x equals to 0 line. I need to represent minus 1. So this is the point. And next on x is equals to 1, the value is 3. So this is the x equals to 1 line. So we need to represent 3. So 3 is here. I am representing this one. Now draw a line by joining minus 1 and 3. So now this is the B1 line, player B first alternative line for the payoff of player A. Like that we need to draw the lines, right? So in a similar way, let us draw the line for the second alternative. So now the second alternative values are 5 and 0. So now let us represent them on x equals to 0 line 5, on x equals to 1 line 0. So I am representing those values on x equals to 0 line. So this is x equals to 0 line and this one is 5. And next on x equals to 1 line, I need to represent 0. So this is x equals to 1 line, so and this is 0 value here. I have represented it. So now draw a line by joining these two points. So I am drawing the line by joining these two points. So now this line will represent second alternative of player B, that is B2. And next, similar way, let us draw the third alternative line. So what are the third alternative values? The third alternative values are minus 2, 6. So now let us draw them. So on x equals to 0, minus 2, and on x equals to 1, 6. So here it is the 6 value. So now draw a line by joining these two points. Right? So now this one is B3. Right? And next, let us draw the fourth alternative. So what is the fourth alternative? The fourth alternative values are 2, minus 1. Let us represent them. So x equals to 0, 2, x equals to 1, it is minus 1. So now draw a line by joining these two points. So now this one is the fourth alternative. Next, let us draw the fifth alternative line. So what is the fifth alternative line? Points are fifth alternative 1, 7. So let us represent them on x equal to 0 line 1, on x equals to 1 line 7. So now draw a line by joining these two points. So this is the line. This one is B5, fifth alternative of player B. Right? So now we have represented all the lines in the graph. So then what to do? So in a 2 by n game, we need to identify the highest point in the lower boundary. So now in this graph, what is higher boundary? What is lower boundary? Let us see. So here, if you see, the upper region is higher boundary and the below one is lower boundary. Upper boundary, lower boundary. Now in this lower boundary, we need to identify the highest point. So now let us identify the lower boundary. So these are the lower boundary. So now first of all, we need to identify the intersection values. So what are the first intersection to this graph by the alternative lines? This is the first intersection. Okay. So now we are moving in this way. So what is the next intersection we got? Here. So this one is B. And then what is the next intersection we got? So then go, we need to look in the lower direction. So in the below this point, there should be no line. Like that, we need to identify the intersection point. So from here onwards, I can move up or I can move in this way. If I move in this direction or if I select this point, below this one alternative line is there. So we should not go in this way. So I need to go in this way. So below this line, there is no any alternative line. So now this is the point C. And next, from here I can go up or I can move down. If I move up, one alternative line will be there. So that's why I need to go in downward direction. So what is the next intersection to the graph? This one. This is T. So don't consider this horizontal line. Okay. And then from here onwards, whether I move to up or down, I need to move down. If I move up, downward, upward direction means the alternative lines will come. So if I move in downward, there are no any alternatives. So this one is the lower boundary. Below these, this line only, we need to identify the region. So this one we are calling it as lower boundary. So now in this lower boundary, what is the highest point? So how many points we got? 4 points we got. So one is A, B, C, D. So in A, B, C, D, what is the highest point? The highest point is C. So now this point we need to consider. So how this point C was formed? The point C was formed because of the intersection of the lines. This is the one line B1 and this is the another line, that is B4. So because of the B1 and B4 lines intersection, the point C was formed. So that's why we need to select the alternatives 1 and 4 in the player B alternatives. So now the reduced matrix will be, so in player B we need to take only 1 and 4 alternatives as point C was formed because of the intersection of alternative lines 1 and 4. So, and there will be two alternatives for player A. So now let us write the reduced payoff matrix. So if you take the payoff matrix which was given in the problem, this is the payoff matrix. Now what are the 1 and 4 alternatives? These are. So now what is the payoff values? 3, minus 1, minus 1, 2. So now let us write them. 3, minus 1, minus 1 and 2. So this one is the reduced payoff matrix, right? So now in this reduced payoff matrix, it is of order 2 by 2. So the 2 by 2 payoff matrix can be solved by algebraic method by finding the oddments. So now without any later, let us find the oddments. So now I am going to find the row oddments. So what are the row oddments? So the difference of 3 and minus 1, 4. The difference of minus 1 and 2, 3. I am writing in up. Similar way, let us find the column oddments. So the difference of 3 and minus 1, 4. I am writing it here. The difference of minus 1 and 2, 3. I am writing it here. Right? So now the oddments we got. Let us find the probabilities of selecting the strategies by the players. So, probability of selecting the strategy 1 by player A, we will take it as P1. Already you know that I explained in the algebraic method. If you did not see in this video, I am going to leave that video in the cards. Please watch it. So, P1 is equals to, what is the first strategy oddment? 3 by sum of oddments 3 plus 4. That equals to 3 by 7, right? So now, what is the second strategy probability of player A? P2, that equals to, so the second strategy oddment is 4. So 4 divided by sum of oddments is 3 plus 4. That equals to 4 by 3 plus 4 is 7. So therefore, for a player A, the probability of strategies of selecting is equals to A, P1, P2 equals to, P1 is 3 by 7 and P2 is 4 by 7. These are the probabilities. Now, let us calculate for player B. So, what are the alternatives we selected? P1, P4. So, then the probabilities we will get are Q1, Q4. So, now let us find for player B, Q1 is equals to. So, for first alternative, what is the oddment? 3. So, 3 by sum of oddments, 3 plus 4. So, that equals to 3 by 7. In a similar way, let us find the probability of selecting the strategy 4. So, Q4 is equals to, what is the oddment of our strategy 4? It is 4 by sum of oddments 3 plus 4. So that equals to 4 by 7. Now let us write the probabilities of player B. So player B totally having 5 strategies. Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q5. So that equals to, so Q1 probability is 3 by 7. Q2, so the second strategy was eliminated. Second and third strategies are eliminated. So the probabilities of selecting them are 0, 0. Next, what is the fourth strategy probability? 4 by 7. Next, the fifth strategy was also eliminated. There is no fifth strategy. So that's why the probability of selecting that strategy is 0. So like this we will write. And then let us finally find the value of the game. So value of the game is represented by V. That equals to, let us find the value of the game. So 3 into 3 plus minus 1 into 4 divided by 3 plus 4. So by using that formula, I said that. So 3 into 3 plus minus 1 into 4 divided by 3 plus 4. That equals to 3 into 3, 9, minus 1 into 4, minus 4 by 3 plus 4 is 7. That equals to 5 by 7 is the value of the game. So here the value of the game, we got it as positive value. So that's why the player A will win the game by 5/7 points. So like this, we are going to solve the game theory problems of order 2/n with the help of graphical method. So I hope you understand this this one. If you understand this, please like this video and subscribe to the channel and share this video. Thank you.